Come on, get in.
UCLA, Empire Bay's news leader. I'm Bob Berryman. If Granny calls and you missed her call,
right.
You still might
so be. So you heard anything about the Mix lately?
No.
The Mix got themselves a new boss. Name's Mickey Desmond. There's a few other guys who want to take his spot. So he's trying to show everybody that he means business.
What the hell does that have to do with me?
Brian O'Neill. He was Desmond's cousin.
I should have known.
My money's on him being down at that shithole joint right now. Laughing it up with the rest of those fucking yo-yos.
So let's get over there and deal with them.
That's the plan. Sounds like there ain't many of them left. So I guess we should just storm the place, surprise the shit out of them.
I like this plan. Assholes burnt my fucking house down.
Relax, we'll be there in a minute. Shit, you're gonna need a piece. I almost forgot.
Yeah, if you got one, that'd be good. If not, I'll just beat them to death with my bare hands. It makes no difference to me.
Should be one in here somewhere. Here it is. Here you go.
Thanks.
Ready, Vito? Come on, let's go get these fucks.
I told you. I chased him, but I lost him. The coward ran away. But I'll find him. And when I do...
You were the one who ran away, asshole.
Fuck. You. You've got some balls.
Yes, I do.
Oh, that asshole shot me. Fuck.
I told you. I chased him, but I lost him. The coward ran away. But I'll find him. And when I do...
You were the one who ran away, asshole.
Fuck. You. You've got some balls.
Yes, I do.
You're fucking dead! Fuck. Show yourself. Is that the fucking best you got? Oh, you're in trouble.
Hey, there's more of them in that car. Let's go, they're getting away.
All right, come on, you drive. Come on, Vito, faster, we're gonna lose them. Ah, shit, we lost them. Ah, come on, let's just get out of here.
Fine, I need a drink anyway.
Well, that takes care of that, huh?
Yeah, but it don't give me my house back.
Don't worry. Business is looking good. You'll have the cash for a new one real soon.
Yeah, I sure as hell hope so.
All right. Let's go back home.
So it's okay if I crash on your couch, right?
I can do one better than that. Here, take these keys. They're for Marty's apartment. I'm trying to get rid of it right now for his mother. So, you might as well use it.
I got a Caucasian man carrying a handgun.
I guess.
Don't thank me, buddy.
Copy that.
You're too old to be sleeping
in
on my
pursuit
couch.
Of a speeding
Plus,
vehicle.
I just bought the thing. I don't want you lousing.
10-4.
Marty's apartment's over in Oyster Bay. So you feel better now?
Not really. What we did back there doesn't even start to make up for it.
Hey, all that stuff they got burnt up is just things, Vito.
Just things. Hey, those were my things, Joe. Why do you think I do the shit we do anyway? It's to buy things.
I got a Caucasian man carrying a
hand. Suits, cars, broads, houses. Now I'm back to scratch. And all my damn cash was in that house, too. I promised myself
10-4.
I'd never be poor again.
I got a Caucasian man carrying a handgun.
Hey, hey, I understand. Don't worry, we'll think of something. You'll be back on your feet in no time.
Glass is always fucking half full with you, isn't it?
Delta Radio, EDLT, Empire Bay.
Some idiot just drove into us. We're bringing him in. Roger that.
Okay, I'll see you around, I guess.
See you, buddy. Sorry about tonight.
What a fucking dump. God, I wish I had the cash for a hotel. Fuck, this is creepy. My house burned to the ground, along with almost every penny I had. There was even some trouble with the cops, but Eddie took care of that. And since I didn't have any insurance, I had to live in this shithole of an apartment till I could get back on my feet. At least I managed to save Leo. He disappeared without a trace. I doubt Frank Vinci even knew where he went. And even though Henry failed to deliver on the contract, Eddie still brought him in when he heard Leo had skipped town. Me and Joe had a new partner. Hey.
Listen, I'm setting up something big. I want you to come in on it. If you're interested in hearing more, come meet me at Lincoln Park and bring a piece.
Okay. I'll see you there.
Excuse me.
Hey, here he comes.
Hey!
What's up?
Hey, Vito. Take a seat.
All right, listen. I've been doing some research at the Carlos business.
So?
So, the only reason he had Clemente killed was because he was selling dope, too. And he was stealing his customers. Now he just needs to get rid of one last obstacle. The one guy who could fuck things up and ruin his plan to become the main supplier for the whole city. Frank Vinci.
Where'd you get all this?
I talked to a few people I trust.
Okay, so what does this have to do with us?
Cause, if he can do it, why can't we? A kilo of heroin costs 2,500 bucks over in France. Then it's another 1,000 bucks to get it here.
And?
And we pick up 11 grand for just driving the stuff to the dealers. That's 7,500 bucks profit a kilo.
Yeah, but what about Falcone?
Carlo won't find out. And even if he does, he'll just threaten us and demand a cut.
All right, but if Carlo's the only big supplier in the city, where are you gonna buy the stuff from?
I'm way ahead of you. What do you two know about the Tongs?
The Chinks?
Some kind of organization for Chinese immigrants, right?
That's what I said, the Chinks.
Right, but it's also a front for their other operations. They run the Chinese quarter, and they keep to themselves. But some of them are interested in doing business with outsiders, and they need middlemen since most people are afraid to deal with them.
And we're the middlemen.
Yep. They'll give us 10 kilos to start.
For how much?
35 grand.
And we can sell it for...
110.
Nice.
Okay, well, where the hell are we gonna get our hands on 35 grand?
I know a loan shark. The Yid over on Palisade. I think a loan is 35, we give him 45 back. Now that means our take is over 20 grand a piece. Not bad for just moving the shit from one place to another.
But you know, who's gonna end up using this crap?
What do you care? As long as it isn't in our neighborhood.
Because Vinci was right. Drugs are bad news, they kill people.
Look, only idiots do drugs. Deadbeats and losers. If they want to kill themselves so badly, I'd gladly help them out. Especially for 20 grand. I got buyers in the ghetto. They'll take care of the distribution. So we don't need to worry about that. Are you guys in or not?
I'm in. Come on, don't be stupid, Vito. 20 fucking grand in one afternoon.
When?
Right now. If we don't take the offer, the towns will just find somebody else.
Come on, Vito, it'll be a piece of cake.
Let's go see Bruno, then. Vito, how about you run us all down there? He's on Palisade Street.
Okay, let's go.
So who's this guy we're gonna see, Henry?
His name's Bruno. He's one of the only guys in town who could do a loan this big.
What if he doesn't give it to us, then what?
Then the deal's off. But don't worry, I know this guy. He'll give us the money.
There ain't nobody else we can get this kind of money from?
There's three other guys I know of. But if you want to ask Carlo or Frank Vinci for 35 grand, be my guest.
Yeah, no thanks.
Who's the third guy?
He ain't in business no more. Somebody blew up a room full of his guys and shot him point blank in the face with a Tommy gun.
Oh, that guy.
Come on, we said we wasn't gonna talk about that.
All right, so, Henry, what is this guy, rich or something?
I think he gets his money from some of the bosses from out of town who sit on the commission.
Yeah? No shit.
Yeah, which is why we can't stiff the guy. Besides, we gotta keep this quiet.
Can we trust him?
Sure. Wise guy's been borrowing money from this guy forever. As long as we pay him back on time, we won't have a problem. Okay, this is it. Stop here.
Hi, fellas. We're here to see Bruno.
Hiya, Henry. If you got guns on yous, put them down there. I gotta search yous.
Hiya, Bruno.
Hello, Henry. So, to what do I owe the pleasure of your company today?
I need 35 grand in $20 bills.
Oh, that's a lot of money, Henry. A lot of money. Tell me, why should I give that much to a small-time guy like you, huh? Convince me.
I got a sure thing. You'll have 45 by the end of the week.
What kind of sure thing?
Sorry, Bruno. That's a trade secret.
Then 45 is not enough. I'd be more comfortable with 65.
It's a bit steep, even for you. 50's all I can do.
Henry, I have no guarantee I'll get my money back. And you have nowhere else to go. So, how about 60? Don't think of it as interest. It's more like my cut of the profits.
55, final offer. Anything more than that, it's not worth my time.
Deal. I'll give you $35,000 today, and you'll give me $55,000 by Friday. If you don't pay it back by then, the debt goes up by $10,000 every week.
You'll get it by Friday.
Okay. Isaac, prepare $35,000 in $20 bills. Now, you know I trust you, Henry, but if you screw me, remember these wise words from the Bible. And my wrath shall wax hot, and I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless.
Exodus, chapter 22, verse 24.
I'm impressed. You don't seem like the church-going type. But just remember, the money isn't mine. So even if you get rid of me, that doesn't get rid of your debt. So no funny business, okay, boys?
Sure, Bruno.
Thank you, Isaac. You want to count it, Henry?
I'll take your word for it, and I'll bring it back on Friday along with your cut.
I hope so. Good luck, boys.
Nice job, Henry.
Of course. I told you give us the dough, didn't I?
How come you know the Bible so good, Henry? You read it or something?
Bruno always uses the same quote. I go to church on Sunday, so I asked the police one time.
You go to church?
Yeah, and I can understand why you don't. They use big words, there's no hookers, and the food's lousy.
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up.
In pursuit of a speeding vehicle.
45.
What?
Roger that.
That time your mother made you go to confession?
Yeah, that time she smacked me for checking out some chick's cool. God rest her soul.
How about you, Joe? How long's it been?
Easter.
Ah, that ain't too bad.
1941.
I take that back then. You're going straight to hell.
What, you just figuring that out now?
Don't worry. I'll save seats for the both of you. You know, I heard about a loan shark named Bruno once. Must be the same guy.
Yeah? Who'd you hear?
Well, you know Mickey the Crab, right?
What, the guy who cleans the bathrooms at Carlos joint?
Yeah, the guy who's only got a finger and a thumb on his left hand. Guess how that happened? I heard he owed a lot of money to some yid from Southport. You get my drift?
Oh, right. I get the picture.
Haha, don't worry, though. Crab's a moron. Nothing like that's gonna happen to us.
Hey, genius. Red light means stop.
Now, first things first. Nothing gets you more energy than a Swift Cola. Secondly, nothing gets you more energy than a Swift Cola. No,
I'm all right, we're almost there. Levels. Drive through the gate and into the yard.
It's worth repeating that the best possible way to get that extra ounce of energy for the big meeting, for the next at-bat or playtime with Junior, is a Swift. So the next time you're feeling sluggish or tired, grab an ice-cold Swift. When you need a lift, you need a Swift.
Now just follow me. Hey, we got some business with your boss.
Greetings, Mr. Tomasino.
Welcome, Henry.
Hello, Mr. Wong.
Let us get straight to business. Is your suitcase heavy enough?
See for yourself.
Yo, Doc, this is 10磅重的20元美金钞票，一共35,000块。
All right, take it away and bring the goods. You're a good man, Henry. Here is your merchandise. Each bag contains 1 kilo. Each kilo weighs a little more than 2 pounds. Which one do you want to test?
Okay, we're good.
I'm glad. Next time, we can give you twice the amount.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Wong.
The pleasure was all mine.
Knock it off. See how easy that was? Get back in the car.
All right, fellas, the hard part's over. Now we just gotta make the exchange and we're done.
Sounds good to me.
Where are we headed?
Hunters. I got it all lined up.
Hello, gentlemen.
Fucking setup.
I think you have something for us. Drop the suitcases.
Hmm. Nice shoes.
Wait a minute. These guys ain't cops.
Kill the bastard! Shoot Vito!
Vito, watch our back.
Going in!
You fuck!
I'm back! Here comes more of them!
Hold on.
I got it.
Bingo.
Nice!
Oh, shit! Can't go back that way! Run!
Move your asses!
Get out of there, Vito! Is that all you got?
Vito, watch our back!
here. Let's get down there.
Vito, kick the door in.
Let's go, Vito.
Right, oh, Vito. That's the best you got.
Back me up, Vito.
He's mine. I'm back. All right, Vito. Go, go, go.
Another one bites the dust.
You okay? You okay?
All right, I'm gonna try and get the high.
Let's get it.
Way to get
you.
Cover me, you shoot like my sister.
Bring it on, motherfucker!
Got him!
Hey, I'm right here, scumbag!
All right, show me, Vito. I'm going in!
This one's mine!
Jeez, relax, will you?
Shit, that was fucking close.
It's not over yet. They're coming after us.
Fuck, lose them.
Oh shit, you all right? He's mine.
You're fucking dead.
What the fuck was that, Henry?
No idea. Somebody else must have known about the deal. Those definitely weren't real cops.
Maybe it was the chinks trying to fuck us.
I doubt it. Look, I'll figure it out. But first, we gotta unload this stuff. Vito, take us to the old warehouse in Hunters.
All right. Hope this deal goes better than the last one.
It will. Not like it can go any worse, right?
So who are we selling the stuff to?
A bunch of different guys.
Oh, whoa, whoa. What do you mean, a bunch of different guys?
A bunch of different guys. What did all that shooting back there make you deaf?
I thought you said we were just moving this garbage from one place to another.
Yeah, well, you make a lot more money if you sell it in smaller amounts.
Would have been really nice to know before I agreed to go in on this.
If I did, from the way you were talking back in the park, you probably wouldn't have.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, the best you could hope for right now is to spend the next 30 years of your life breaking your ass for Eddie and Carlo before you either get bumped off or end up back in the can. The only time you're ever gonna see cash like this is if you stick your neck out. Besides, I ever steer you wrong?
Well, there was the OPA job. And that time we almost got killed when we wiped that fat fucking Sand Island.
All right, enough. None of that matters after today. Let's just get the hunters. And don't worry, we're never gonna have to see these scumbags again after today.
Unless this turns into a regular thing for us.
Well, all right, let's just concentrate on getting through this one before we go making plans like that, all right?
Hey, I'm just saying.
Vito's right. Let's just get through the rest of the day. After that, smooth sailing, fellas.
Here we are. Let me do the talking. These are tough guys, so no wise-ass comments. All right, Joe. Hey, guys, how you doing?
Hey, man. Come on in.
We hit the jackpot.
Hey, 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 take it easy. We're not done yet.
Lighten up, will you, Henry? What's the matter? All of a sudden, money don't make you happy?
After we pay back Bruno and you get your cut, then you could be happy.
All right, all right.
So listen to side, baby, diamond ring. If that diamond ring don't shine, he gon' take it to a private eye. If that private eye can't see, he better take the ring from me. Oh, dear, they call her Nanny Go. To make a pretty baby a Sunday Go. Oh, dear, they call her Bellcat. To make a pretty baby a Sunday Hat.
You ain't even gonna give me a tip?
You want a tip? I'll give you a tip. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Always the gentleman, huh, Joey?
Just get the fuck out of here already.
Hey, Gina, wanna come join me?
Hey, I hope there's room for three in there. Barbaro's Bordello. You got the money, we got the honeys.
Vito, it's Henry. We got a problem.
What kind of problem?
Eddie paid me a visit. Carlo knows about the deal, and he sent Eddie to pick up his cut.
How much?
60 grand.
Fuck, that much? What are we gonna do?
I don't know. We don't even have enough left for Bruno. Meet me in the park. I don't want to talk about this over the phone.
Okay. I'll be right there. Joe, we gotta go.
What? What for?
Now, Joe.